Through tons of lightning also involved in these storms, and we're going to continue to monitor for that as we make our way throughout your morning hours. So what we're taking a look at here, you can see this is at the top of the Yum Center. Visibility obviously significantly compromised with these storms moving through. We're also going to continue to monitor for the possibility of some very powerful winds with these storms, and we're going to watch for that. Yes, Dave? Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Great. Let's go ahead and show you what's happening. So we are watching for this set of storms that are going to continue to move down to the southeast. And you'll notice that we are seeing some pretty strong winds associated with these storms moving through anywhere from 50 to 60 miles per hour. So some damaging winds are certainly a possibility as we make our way throughout the morning hour. So we're going to be watching for the severe thunderstorm warning to continue until 9:15 for about another 10 minutes. Not picking up much as far as rotation here, but certainly some very strong winds associated with these storms. This severe thunderstorm warning will continue until 9:15 this morning. And you can see these storms moving into St. Matthews, moving into Germantown, Audubon Park, heading into the Shively area, St. Denis, Hazelwood as well. We're watching for these storms moving through areas of Buckner, through Brownsboro as well. So you'll notice as we give you that live look outside, this is from our KFC Yum Center camera, and you can see that just torrential rain continuing to move through. I want to give you the perspective from a few other locations. I'll switch over our routers here and show you from our tower camera. Again, you can't even see what's going on here because that rain is coming down so heavily at this point. So you'll notice again, there is the severe thunderstorm warning. It does include pretty much the entire area of Louisville. It also includes portions of Oldham County into portions of Shelby County as well. So torrential downpours, lots of lightning involved in this storm as well. So we haven't had any reports out of the metro as of yet, but certainly we are looking at the possibility of some very strong winds associated with this storm. This is right on top of St. Matthews now, moving through Seneca Gardens, through South Parkland, through Shively, right along 264. You're seeing that storm continue to make its way down to the east southeast. So let's go ahead and track this storm for you, show you what's happening as we take a look. You'll notice, again, pushing down to the east southeast at about 40 to 45 miles per hour. So that's going to take it to Linview. Right now, Poplar Woods at about 908 into areas of Wildwood. We're also going to be watching that through Watterson Park, West Butchel, and Hurstbourne. You know what? If we've got our master control op, Dave, listening, I wonder if we should do a quick cut-in on WLKY as well, just during this commercial break, just as that storm continues to move on through. Dave, if we could go ahead and do that. I don't know if you've got my IFB up. If we could do that, Dave, if you can hear me. You can hear me? Okay, we need to just do a quick cut in here.
Do you need to set up a cut in?
No, we just need to do one. Okay. Can you get him, Drew? So we're continuing to watch these storms as they're moving through. We have now had some additional severe thunderstorm warnings that have been issued a little bit farther down to the south now, including portions of Bullitt County. And again, through sections of Jefferson County as well, we are seeing some strong storms continuing to move on through. So we'll get you in a little bit closer, show you where these storms are headed into areas of Anchorage at about 10 past 9. We're going to see this moving through Douglas Hills at about 9:11, heading into Okolona at about 9:11 here. into Middletown again at about 9:11. But we have seen the National Weather Service extend this warning down a little bit farther down to the south. So it now includes portions of Bullitt County, Nelson County, and Spencer County as well. And this would be for the potential of some very strong winds. So we're going to watch that continue to make its progression down to the east southeast. So some very strong storms moving through Barbara Meade, through Linden, heading into the Douglas Hills area in the next couple of minutes. This is heading into Jefferson Town, Lake Forest, heading into Eastwood, moving throughout areas of Fairdale. And again, we're seeing that pushing through PRP, through Shively, through Germantown, through the downtown area. We're going to continue to watch for that storm to continue to push down to the east southeast at about 40 to 45 miles per hour. So you can see that again continuing to make its progression. So this is going to be heading into the Anchorage area in just the next couple of seconds. Okolona at about 9:12, Woodland Hills at about 9:13, Ballardsville at about 9:13 as well. So just to do kind of a reset here and show you what's going on, we're continuing to see that very heavy rainfall moving through. This is a live look from some of our cameras here, and you can see visibility is pretty much down to zero at this point. I want to pull up some of our Trimark cameras, also show you what's happening. You can see a pretty ominous looking sky. This is a look over by the Gene Snyder and Taylorsville Road, and you can see again a very darkening sky right there with those storms that are going to continue to make their way down to the east southeast. This is a look at 64 into the downtown area. This is a check of 264 right near Taylor Boulevard, and you'll notice again very heavy rainfall moving through. Taking a look at a few other areas, this is 65 right near Crittenden Drive. I know we've got a lot of people that are going to be heading out of town in the next couple of minutes, and we're going to continue to be looking at not great driving conditions and not great flying conditions either. So again, just to do kind of a reset here, we are watching for this line of shower and thunderstorm activity to continue to be moving through the greater Louisville area. And in doing so, that is going to continue to bring some very strong winds and also the potential, obviously, of torrential downpours. That's what we've been seeing so far this morning. So again, we've got a couple of warnings out there. We've got a severe thunderstorm warning over portions of the Louisville Metro, as well as throughout areas of Bullitt County, moving into sections of Nelson County for these storms. So far, we did get some reports into some locations of some downed trees, and obviously we are seeing some very heavy rainfall associated with these storms. So we're going to be watching that as it continues to move on through. Right now, the severe thunderstorm warning is expected to expire at about 9:15 in about 3 minutes, but we have another severe thunderstorm warning that has been issued for areas of Nelson County and Spencer County as well. And that does include the very southern sections of Jefferson County, Kentucky, and the Louisville Metro. So right now we're watching that storm moving over the heart of the metro at this point. You can see with some very heavy rainfall and just a ton of lightning strikes. Let's go ahead and kind of do a deep dive into this and talk a little bit about some of the winds that we may be seeing. Again, some very strong winds associated with some of these storms as they're continuing to move through. We did get some reports farther off to the north of some strong winds as well. So we'll continue to monitor for the threat of any damaging winds. This is going to continue to push down to the east southeast at about 40 to 45 miles per hour. So we'll be watching that closely for you. Again, pushing down at about 45 miles per hour. Dave's there, so we can do a cut. I've got it. Got it in right now. So we're continuing to watch for these storms, continuing to move on through the WLKY viewing area. And we do have... Never mind. So we're watching for this continuing to push on through. So we've got a severe thunderstorm warning. Again, pushing down to the south, you'll notice this is going to be heading into the Hunter's Hollow area at about 9:17, Todd's Point at about 9:17, near Fern Creek at about 9:16, the Lake Forest area at about 9:15 this morning. So again, They're going to allow the parts of that severe thunderstorm warning, that northern fringe, that's allowed to expire. Farther down to the south, that warning continues until 9:30 this morning. So again, it's a pretty short warning. I want to show you the visibility here. It is obviously significantly reduced. You can see a look here at Interstate 65 right at Crittenden Drive. We're continuing to monitor for that threat of very heavy rainfall. And obviously, we have had some reports of some very, very heavy rain across sections of southern Indiana, anywhere from about 1 to 2 inches. So again, this warning is going to be allowed to expire. This one that you're seeing here into the greater Louisville area. This one that extends farther down into Bullitt County and into Nelson County. That warning will continue until 9:30, and that is for that southern flank of the storm system continuing to push down to the south. Now, if you're over into portions of, let's say, southern Harrison County, we're going to be watching for that storm there. That's going to continue to push down to the east, southeast as well. Farther to the north, things have started to dry out across sections of southern Indiana. And you can see we're going to continue to look for that heavy rainfall moving across portions of Henry County back into Oldham County as well. But the only warning that we have left is for portions of Bullitt County. And that is going to continue to push down to the east, southeast until 9:30 this morning. But a very healthy storm you can see moving across areas of Jefferson County so far this morning.
The warning expired, so
and we missed that. So you can see, let's take you into portions of Valley Station, Parkwood. I'll pull up some of our Trimark cameras so you can get a view of what's happening here. That's again 65 right near Crittenden Drive that you're taking a look at. Checking out a few other locations, 264 at Taylor Boulevard. You can see some of that heavy rainfall continuing to overspread the region. 64 into the downtown area. Again, just picking up that heavy rainfall. Doesn't look terribly windy here from this perspective at 64. This is a little bit closer over to 22nd Street. Taking a look as you're heading into the downtown area on the right-hand side of your screen on 64. Traffic is, you can see, still moving smoothly and pretty light at this time. Here is a quick check of a few other spots here this morning. You can see, again, with that kind of bird's eye perspective with our Trimark cameras, some of that very heavy rainfall continuing to pass on through. So we're going to continue to monitor for this line of storms as it moves through. And this has been quite a healthy line of thunderstorm activity that we have seen so far this morning. So you'll notice farther to the north, we are a little bit quieter now across portions of Washington County, Indiana, through Scott County, just seeing some of that garden variety shower activity. The healthiest storms that we're currently watching, those are continuing to move through areas of Newburgh, through Jefferson Town, heading over into Long Run, over into Crestwood. So we're certainly going to be watching for that as we make our way throughout the morning hours. And again, it's definitely some very heavy rainfall that we're continuing to monitor right now moving through. We still have that one severe thunderstorm warning that does include portions of Bullitt County in the very southern sections of Jefferson County as well. So we did get some reports into sections of Du Bois County of some thunderstorm wind damage. So we're going to be looking at that. We've got winds that were reported up to 43 miles per hour at the airport, and that's going to be pushing into portions of Bullitt County as well. So some gusty winds certainly are expected as we make our way throughout the morning hour, so we'll be watching for that. I'm going to go ahead and try to set this up and put this onto our Facebook page as well, so you can monitor from there if you're just joining us this morning. So we're going to be looking at heavy rainfall moving through the Newburgh area, through sections of Jefferson County. Again, we just have that one severe thunderstorm warning that we're watching. I'm going to just type this up real quick. So we haven't had any reports into the metro of any damage. Certainly it's a very noisy storm that you're probably hearing right now. And so we're going to be looking at some very heavy rainfall, and certainly we're watching for some pockets of torrential downpours as well. So into the Newburgh area, seeing that heavy rainfall here, heading into Fern Creek, Jefferson Town, you're getting in on some of the action as well. Anchorage, also some very heavy rainfall for you. Storms continue to move into portions of northern Bullitt County here this morning. You can see that right there. We're also going to continue to monitor for perhaps some standing water on some of the local roads as well. We're going to be looking at some damage. Potentially we're getting some reports of some damage near the IUS campus, so we'll have to keep you posted about that. Watching for heavy rainfall moving through LaGrange into Campbellsburg, Corydon, also seeing some of that heavy rainfall as well. So as far as those warnings that we're going to be monitoring for, you'll notice that we just have that one warning that has been left into sections of Bullitt County, into portions also, it looks like, into southern Jefferson County, and that continues until 9:30 this morning. So we'll be monitoring for that. So we're going to be looking for, again, some very heavy rainfall, and also the possibility, of course, of some very gusty winds. So far, we've only had reports of about 40 to 45 mile per hour winds. So we're going to be keeping that in mind as we make our way throughout your morning hour. So let's go ahead and track kind of the southern flank of this storm. We did get some reports of some wind damage across areas of Harrison County, where a tree is down across State Road 64 near New Salisbury. And again, we're going to be monitoring for the potential of some gusty winds with this particular storm system. You can see moving into sections of Bullitt County, tracking to the east southeast, and at about, let's say, about 40 to 45 miles per hour. So we can go ahead and do a bit of a storm track on that and show you where that storm is headed so far this morning. Near Shepherdsville at about 9:22, Highgrove at about 9:31, Claremont at 9:35, Wakefield at 9:42, near Cox's Creek at about 9:46 here this morning. So we'll be watching for that storm continuing to move on through. We haven't had any reports from the bottom half or the southern part of that storm so far this morning, but we will certainly keep you posted about that. Very, very heavy rainfall continues to move through the WLKY viewing area so far this morning. And you can see we're going to continue to monitor for the threat of some very gusty winds. So far, we have had some reports of some winds about 40 to 45 miles per hour moving through portions of the WLKY viewing area. And we're going to continue to watch for the possibility of some of those gusty winds as they continue to move on through. So right now it looks like maybe a few stronger winds showing up into the Fairmont area near Asheville, perhaps some stronger winds there, and maybe heading into areas of Shepherdsville and Gap and Knob. So we'll be watching for that as we make our way through. You'll notice a ton of lightning also involved in some of these storms as they continue to make their progression down to the south. As far as those warnings that are concerned, we still have that one warning that continues for about the next 8 minutes. And that's for areas of Bullitt County and to portions of southern Jefferson County as well. We'll be watching for that as we make our way throughout the rest of your morning hours for that line to continue to make its progression down to the south. We'll be watching for the possibility of some gusty winds associated with that line of shower and thunderstorm activity as it moves into that warm, moist air. So again, if you're just hopping on to the Facebook Live or our WLKY.com Live, we're watching for a line of shower and thunderstorm activity continuing to move down to the south. And we are watching for some very heavy rainfall. We have had some reports, it looks like, into portions of Floyd County, perhaps of some downed trees and downed power lines from some of those winds gusting through. So we'll be keeping that in mind. Obviously, we want you to stay away from any power lines. We did get some reports of some thunderstorm wind damage into sections of Harrison County, Indiana. So we'll be keeping that in mind as we make our way throughout the morning hours. Obviously, we want to be especially careful of any downed trees or downed power lines. Let's go ahead and show you kind of a look, live look outside. You can see some very heavy rainfall moving along areas of the Gene Snyder and Taylorsville Road. A live look from our tower camera. you'll notice significantly reduced visibility here. Obviously, that rain is coming down in buckets here this morning. As we make our way throughout your morning hours, we're going to continue to have to look for the threat of some additional shower and thunderstorm activity developing. It looks like, again, this is that one line of storms moving through. However, as we head into tonight, we're going to keep our eyes peeled for the possibility of some additional shower and thunderstorm activity moving through. So some gusty winds, perhaps into areas of Mount Washington, moving into central areas of Bullitt County. This will be heading into the Claremont area soon, near Samuels into Nelson County, where that severe thunderstorm warning does remain until 9:30 this morning. So we're watching for heavy rainfall and gusty winds. If you're over into sections of Shelby County, you don't have any warnings for your area at this time, but perhaps some heavy rainfall. And into portions of Valley Station, right along areas of Dixie Highway, we're also watching for some pockets of very heavy rainfall into the PRP area and portions of Valley Station. So keep that in mind as we watch for some additional heavy rainfall right along 64, a little bit south of 64. We're going to be looking at some pockets of heavy rainfall into the Radcliffe area, some heavy rainfall that's going to be moving into your area relatively soon as well. So keep that in mind. We're going to be on air watching for these storms as they continue to move on through. So we're going to be looking at that severe thunderstorm warning again. That's going to expire in about 5 minutes. So I want to go ahead and give you a quick look at the forecast. As we make our way throughout your morning hours, we'll watch for that line of showers and storms to continue to move on through. And that will continue for some of our southern communities into the afternoon hours. And we'll be keeping that in mind. We're watching for another chance of additional shower and thunderstorm activity as we head into tonight as well. So we're not quite done with the action yet, unfortunately. So let's see. If you are, let us know if you're what you're seeing in your area. If you're on our Facebook Live here this morning or on WLKY.com, we always appreciate your letting us know what's happening in your area. It's always super helpful. So we're not done with some of the active weather. It looks like still a chance for our seeing some more storms as we make our way into tonight as well. As far as what we have from the Storm Prediction Center, we have, for the most part, for our area, we're under that marginal risk category for today and for tomorrow, still under that marginal risk category. So again, marginal risk category, that slight risk category is a little bit farther off to the west, but that doesn't mean that we can't see some strong to severe storms. And certainly we have seen some active weather so far this morning with just some of those downpours and also very gusty winds moving through portions of the WLKY viewing area. Here's a look from kind of the front lawn of WLKY. You can see some of that rain coming down here this morning. A look at some of our Trimark cameras will also show you we're seeing some pockets of heavy rainfall as well. Let me show you a few more of our Trimark cameras. And you can see, again, some pockets of heavy rainfall continuing to move on through the metro. So we'll continue to keep you posted. That severe thunderstorm warning does continue until 9:30 this morning, and that has been allowed to expire. So we're going to do a little bit of a reset, and we'll come back on if there are any more warnings that have been issued.